Roar! Or whatever.
Hey Dino fans, D-Rex here, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Jurassic World trading cards that have come out with Fallen Kingdom. This is how you will find them in the store. They are normally $1.99 a pack at Target, but I went ahead and I purchased an entire box sealed from Target. You can only do this online, and the box was $36. That makes them about $1.50 a piece, I think. So they're just a tiny bit cheaper if you buy an entire sealed box. Now you can see here on the front of the package, we have the Jurassic World logo, the artwork with the erupting volcano, and the Velociraptor blue. It says trading cards, 7 cards per pack. And it also says to look for authentic costume cards. So we'll be looking for those. Here's what the back of the package looks like. You can see that it is made by Bullsitoy again. Bullsitoy.com. And you can see that the packs are inside here. I don't know why there are holes in the box, but a sealed box like this is supposed to contain 24 packs of cards. And when you find it in the store, it'll be open like this, and the packs of cards will be sticking out of the bottom. Now, if we take a look at one of the individual packs, we can see that it has the same artwork. It's the Jurassic World logo, the Velociraptor blue. It says 7 cards per pack. Now, on the back of the pack, again, it says Bullseye Toy. It also says trading cards, 7 cards per pack. There are 88 cards in the set to collect, and of those, 39 are film scene cards, 15 are dino cards, 9 are glow-in-the-dark cards, 9 are heat and reveal cards, 9 are 3D action cards, and 7 are costume cards. And it says you have a 1 in 24 chance of finding one. So, since I bought a full box sealed, it's supposed to have 24 packs with 7 cards in it. It also comes with a plastic display connector so that you can hang the box from the display shelf. So the first thing I've done is empty the box and count the packs. And I do in fact have 24 packs of cards. Now, many collectors of various kinds of cards would do everything they could to preserve this package for their cards. And, spoiler alert, I bought one pack of cards the other day just to see what they were. And, I was able to very carefully pull and get this to come open, get the glue to release, and I was able to open it without tearing the pack or cutting it. Then it's not easy to do, and I don't want to do it for 24 packs. So because I want to open them and I want to look at all my cards and see if I have a full set or not, I'm just going to use my scissors and very carefully cut along as close to the glue as I can, and open them all so that they slide out. What I'm going to do is open all the packs and put them in order and into their different groups, and then I will tell you what I received in my one sealed box. So give us a few and we'll be right back. As you can see, I am almost done here, but I wanted to show you how I've been opening these. What they intend for you to do, I don't know if you can see it or not. There's a tiny little notch at each end of the package. There's one on there and one there, and they're on one side. What they intend for you to do is to take hold of it and tear the package. Now, I don't like doing this, because as you can see, I have to put a lot of pressure because it's very thick material. And you could scuff the cards when they rub together, Or you could potentially bend them by having to push on them too hard. So, instead what I have done, when you pick it up, you can feel inside without applying too much edge pressure because you don't want to bend the edges, but you can feel where the cards are in the pack. There's a little bit of room at each end. Now, the cards are pretty compressed together. So when you pick the package up, I've been cutting the bottom end because this top end has a lot going on and I don't want to get into the cards. So what I do here is I let them gently slide down together by squeezing the side of the package, or sometimes they just do it on their own. And I'm not too worried about scuffing them this way because, like I said, they're very compressed together until you open them. And then you take your scissors and you cut right along this line where the package has been crimped together. And you can see here's the edge of the cards. Here's plenty of room for my fingers. And then here's the edge where the crimping is. And you can just cut along there. Now it feels, you're going to feel it's a little scary in the middle because it's thicker because there's a folded over bit of the package. But you cut right through that. And it's open. And they just come right out. And that, to me, is the best way to get these open. I think that's the way that other card collectors for other types of cards open their packs. You just cut along the bottom, and then they just come right out. You can see it's just a foil bag, but it's a very thick, sturdy material. So I do not recommend using the tear method, because you can bend up your cards or scratch them by rubbing them against each other. I've got one more pack to open. And then I'm going to sort them into their various types. Okay, Dino fans, let's take a look at the numbers. I bought one sealed box, which was 24 packs with 7 cards in a pack, which was 168 cards. When I got them all open, I had 5 of the 9 3D Dino cards, 5 of the 9 Heat and Reveal cards, 8 of the 9 glow-in-the-dark cards, 12 of the 15 dino character cards, and 35 of 39 film scene cards. There were 0 costume cards in my box. I did not get any of the special 7 cards that you have a 1 in 24 chance of getting. So, in total, I got 65 out of the 88 possible cards, and that means I have 103 cards out of 168, 103 cards that I do not need. If I break down the extras for you, I got 6 extra 3D cards, 8 heat and reveal cards, 16 glow-in-the-dark cards, 20 dino cards, and 53 film scene cards. That means that there were quite a few duplicates, and in some cases, duplicates were good because there were problems. I'll get to that in a minute, but first of all, let me just show you an example of each type of card. I'm not going to show you all the film cards because it might spoil the movie for you if you haven't seen it. So this is the 3D action card, and you can see it's kind of a lenticular card, and depending on which way you tilt it, you either get the Fallen Kingdom logo or one of the dinos. And I'll just show you one more real quick. Kind of a neat effect. If you watch my dog tag video, you know that I got these lenticular kind of 3D effect cards with my dog tags. And if you compare the images, they are not exactly the same, but some of them are similar. Also, the dog tag ones are stickers, and the lenticular ones, the lenticular ones say 3D action dino card, they are numbered. This is number 5 of 9. And it says, angle the card back and forth to see both images. The next kind of card I want to show you is the glow-in-the-dark cards. Hopefully you can see this ankylosaurus glowing green. Here it is with black light shining on it. Got my handy-dandy Jurassic World black light from the toys in 2015. And see, now it lights up really well because I've charged it. See if we can do another one here. Here's the Baryonyx. Oh, come on. It's a very cool looking card in the first place. But you can imagine what these will look like when they're all charged up and ready to go. Here's the Baryonyx in regular light, so you can see what the card actually looks like. And here is that Anky. It's basically a regular picture that they have put glow-in-the-dark ink over. So they're pretty cool. I really like them. Here's a non-spoilery film card. Just a picture of Owen in blue. This one's number 39 of 39. This is the Heat and Reveal card. And it looks pretty cool like that, right? If you get it warm, which I can do with my hand because my hands are very warm, you can see that other stuff starts to show up. You see now where that I've heated it with my hand, more stuff is starting to show up. It's such tiny writing, it's really hard to read, but I believe it's the habitat, the length, the weight, and basic facts about Stegosaurus. And it tells you what dino it is. So here's the difference between a heated card and an unheated card. And as soon as this cools back off, it'll revert back to its original state. So it's really cool. It's like the rub signs on the old G1 Transformers. So I was pretty excited when I saw that. And here we have finally number 11 of 15, Dino card. You can see it has the pronunciation of the dinosaur's name. This is Pachycephalosaurus, according to the pronunciation guide. Pachycephalosaurus, obviously. It has the length, weight, height, the aggression level, intelligence, traits, did you know, and battle facts. It says, for example, Pachycephalosaurus don't just butt heads with each other. In a fight, they often target other parts of the body, ribs, legs, to break those bones with their thick skulls. Pretty vicious fighters from what that says. And already we've found an error. The pronunciation guide is for Pachycephalosaurus. But you can see right here it says Pachyrhinosaurus. And when we flip it over, that's Pachyrhinosaurus, not Pachycephalosaurus. So the pronunciation guide is wrong. Which brings me to the next problem. This is the Stygimoloch, or Stygimoloch, and you can see that they've miscut the back of the card. The pronunciation guide is cut off. They've at least got the right dino on it and everything. And it says Stygimoloch, so that may or may not be correct. That's interesting, because I haven't taken an in-depth look at all of these just yet. But this one's a miscut, and this one's got the wrong information printed on it. A lot of the cards are miscut, meaning they've cut the card so that it cut off the text on the back. It may also be a misprint, in addition to being a miscut, because, as you can see on the front, the image looks correct. I'm not quite sure how the sheets were laid out for these, but that's a problem. And something else I'll tell you, these are like kind of like digital prints from the store, like when you get your digital photos printed, they will thumbprint up. You can see right there, I've got my thumbprint on it. And they will scratch pretty easily. There was issues with adhesion of the ink in the process. Either there was dust on it or something in the machine when it got printed, and the ink did not stick. Other problems include miscut corners. You can see that's kind of not cut all the way and then torn. Bent corners. There's another miscut. You can see that the image at the bottom is cut off from the top. This is a card that I haven't shown you yet, and its main problem is that it's bent. Here's another one, also bent. And this is not from me rough handling. This is how they came out of the package. And you can see this card here has all those scratches and scuffs. Came out of the package that way. This one is very hard to see. I think you can see it there. It has edge curl. Here's another one that's bent. And this one bent really bad. Again, that's not from me. That's how it came out of the package. And it's inconsistent. Like, you'll find some in that package that are totally fine, and then some that are really weird. So I don't know if it's rough handling by the machines or what, but I know I kind of got off on a tangent, but so problems aside, there are things you can do to help secure your cards and to keep them nice. One of the things I'm doing is I'm keeping my extras in this acrylic deck box. You can get these at Target, Walmart, or your local game shop. They fit in there quite nicely, and they won't get scuffed up or bent or anything as long as they're in the box. As for my collection, I've gotten these acid-free 9-card sleeves. These are Ultra Pros, but you can use whatever brand you like. And I put them in this D-ring binder. It's important to get a D-ring binder because you don't want the pages to stick out the edges or anything. And a D-ring will have plenty of room for the entire page sleeve. You can see that it has plenty of room for the page sleeve when it's laying flat, and it doesn't hang off the edge, because if it hung off the edge, then your cards would get bent. Obviously, you want to be careful opening them, like I said. You could open them on a play mat or a soft cloth. You want to make sure that your hands are clean and dry, at the very least. And if you want to take an extra precaution for smudges and scratches and things, you could wear gloves. Obviously, you wouldn't want to wear anything with powder on it or any substance on it, but you could get powder-free gloves or cloth gloves or anything that would protect the cards from the oil on your hands. Something else I wanted to mention briefly is that these hologram cards come a little bit bent. I don't know if they'll relax over time or if they're just going to be bent because of the material they're made of. I suspect that that's the case. But anyway, just something to be aware of. They're a little bit curly. You can see that the cards fit nicely in the 9-card sleeves. I wanted to go over each type of card briefly and give you some feedback on my thoughts on the different kinds of cards. The 3D cards are pretty cool. I don't have too much to say about them. One or two of them, it's very difficult to get the image to change completely. And that could be because it's bent. It could be just the way the image was designed. It doesn't really take away from them that much. The heat and reveal cards, I absolutely love. Just be careful handling them. You don't want to bend your cards. Some of them had bent corners coming out of the package, so They're prone to bend or have edge curl. The glow-in-the-dark ones are pretty cool. I will say this, though. These cards and the dino cards, if they were arranged properly and the backgrounds were done properly, it could have been done like in the style where you would have a great big, like, you'd have a big sheet size image or collage if you put them all in the right order. But none of the cards in this collection are that way. And I feel that might be a missed opportunity. That's something that trading cards normally do, is they have like a special collection that makes a one big picture. Even the old cards did that. So that could be a missed opportunity here. But again, it doesn't take away too much from the fun of collecting them, because you still have a lot of different ones to collect. Now here's the dino cards, as I said. They look like they very easily could have been made into a giant dino collage, but here they are in order, and they in fact do not make a big collage. And you can see the movie images fit nicely in there. I don't want to show you too many of them, just in case you haven't seen the movie, because I don't want to spoil it for you. But the thing that I can say about these is it used to be that they would make movie cards and put them in order and put the story on the back of the card so that you could read along and basically read the story of the movie. These cards skip around all over the place. They don't cover the entire movie, and they don't say anything on the back of them. It just says film card number 1 of 39 or whatever, and it doesn't give you any additional information about the story. It doesn't even tell you who the character is in the picture. So I feel like that's something that they really should have done differently. I think Bullsitoy's, they've got some quality control issues, but that's the biggest issue I have with this collection. In addition to being slightly annoyed that I got 168 cards and only 65 of the 88 in the entire collection out of those 168, I should have realistically had at least one complete set with, you know, more than double the cards in the set. But, and I understand that I didn't get the costume cards. That's okay. They're supposed to be really rare. But I at least should have gotten, you know, the basic film cards. And I'm missing quite a few of those. So, my advice to you is, if you want to take a big chunk of the collection and get them at a slight discount, you can order the boxes. I wouldn't worry about getting them all out of one box, because getting one box doesn't get you the complete collection, not even close. They are $1.99 if you buy them individually at Target. I don't know if that will ever change. Probably not. It usually doesn't. But I don't know. I feel like even though it's $1.99 a pack for 7 cards, see if I get my calculator out here. $1.99. Helps if it's on. $1.99 divided by 7 cards. They're roughly 28 cents a piece. That's 28 American cents a piece. So, I don't know. Paying a quarter for a card, it doesn't seem too bad. It's a shame there's so many errors and scratches and dents and dings and miscuts, and that I didn't get more of the basic cards. But it is what it is. It's all random. They're not marked in any way, so you don't know what you're getting until after you've opened them. Definitely have a plan in mind for how you're going to store them so that they don't get damaged after you open them. Even before you open the packs, you should still be careful with them and make sure they don't get mangled, because they are very prone to damage. It took me quite a while to open all of these and sort them and count them and put them in order. And that's all the time I have for this video. So don't forget to click the like button. It really does help me out. And you guys have been amazing with your support of the channel and the videos. I really do appreciate you. Thank you so much. Don't forget to subscribe. And something else you can do, there's a little bell icon for getting notifications. Make sure that you have clicked that. That way when I post a new video, you'll get a notification in your YouTube feed and you'll know that I've posted something new. It should be every day, but it isn't always. And that's just an easy way for you to get notified when I post something new. And until next time, as always, happy hunting. I have a special treat for those of you who have stuck with me to the end. I'm going to show you my previous card collection pertaining to Jurassic. I have other collections that are not Jurassic related, but let's crack open my binder and take a look at what else I've got. And I bought these at a convention because it was a complete set. I had already collected quite a few of them, but a lot of them got lost or whatever, you know, because I was 12 when I started this mess. But anyway, I have the Topps Jurassic Park cards. You can see there's the character cards, movie. See, this is what I was talking about. On the back of these, it tells you who the character is. It gives you their name and everything. And another detail shot of them. And this one here, like these, this is a movie card. It tells you what scene it is, and then you flip it over, and it explains the scene to you, so you can read along and get the story. I really wish that they'd done that in the Bullsitoy's Fallen Kingdom. And, of course, here are the lovely art cards by Crash, and my favorite one ever right here with the baby velociraptors. I love it so much. I was initially very excited that someone was going to make a sculpture that looked like that, and then I heard the horror stories about quality control and saw the colors that they picked, and I know they worked with Crash on it, but it didn't end up looking like this card enough to suit me, so I didn't end up getting that statue. And here's what I'm talking about when I say that the cards line up to make a big image. They could have easily done that with these dino cards or any of the other sets of 9 in this new pack, and they didn't. And it's so silly because this is such a classic thing that they could have done. I don't know what you're doing, Bullseye, but you're missing opportunities. And it says right here, collect all 10 cards of Puzzle A. And of course there were holographic cards, foil holograms, and they were really cool. I don't have all of those because the set that I bought didn't have all of them, but it is what it is. This Tyrannosaurus Rex card in the middle, in the top here, that I think I got that out of a pizza box. Maybe you guys will have some of those from the first Jurassic World and you can let me know. But the other thing I have in here is my movie cards from out of my action figures that have been opened. So you have those. And I also have the art cards from series 1 of the toys that I opened. And you can see on the back of those, it's like the dino cards because it says the name of it and what it means, length, weight, diet, the period it lived in, the range, and a little blurb and some trivia. So it's very much like the dino cards in the new set. So that part they did okay on, other than, you know, it has incorrect information and it was a miscut. That's another story, I guess. But anyway, I just wanted to show you, give you a quick glance of these other cards that I collected. I recently saw at Universal the Lost World trading cards. Was it Lost World or was it JP3? I think it was Lost World. But they're $6 a pack. No, $7 a pack. $6.99 for one pack of cards. And they don't have nearly, I mean, like, there's no way they have a complete set. So, that's at Williams of Hollywood on, at Universal Orlando. I suppose if you wanted to get some of those while you're visiting Universal, might make a neat addition to your collection. I personally just, I see the $6.99 price tag and I'm like, no. Because if I start, I'm going to want them all, and I can't get them all. But look at conventions, because this whole set of cards for the first movie was like 10 or 15 bucks. Didn't have the holograms, but 10 or 15 bucks for all of the movie cards and the puzzle and everything seemed like a really great deal. So hopefully they haven't gone up too much in price since the Jurassic stuff came back, but we'll see. Just keep your eyes peeled, and you should be able to find a set for a reasonable price. That being said, thanks for sticking with me till the end and looking at my collection with me, and I will see you next time.